This is Mission Control Houston. This week has been a very busy week for the Expedition 34 crew, with a wide range of activities being completed by the crew. One of the biggest activities of this week was being the undocking and docking of the Progress spacecraft. That swap kicked off last weekend with the undocking of the Progress 48 spacecraft, which undocked from the space station last Saturday. With its successful deorbit completed, the Progress 50 spacecraft launched Monday at 8:41 a.m. Central Time from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan to send the Progress on an accelerated four-orbit, six-hour rendezvous to the International Space Station. That single-day launch to docking went by the book, with the cargo craft docking to the orbiting complex's Piers docking compartment on Monday afternoon, bringing with it nearly 3 tons of supplies and equipment. The crew performed leak checks and opened the hatches Tuesday morning, which kicked off the extensive unpacking that has continued throughout the week. Ultimately, the crew will transfer more than 1,700 pounds of propellant, 100 pounds of air and oxygen, 900 pounds of water, and 3,000 pounds of supply items and equipment. While the cosmonauts primarily led that unpacking effort, their U.S. counterparts spent a fair bit of time this week with pre-pack activities for the next visiting vehicle, the Dragon spacecraft. That vehicle is now planned to visit the station in early March, and the team is already making preparations for that visit. Astronaut Tom Marshburn and Chris Hadfield spent a lot of time gathering supplies and equipment that will be loaded onto that vehicle, which has the added capability of being able to return supplies and equipment samples to Earth. In addition, with Commander Kevin Ford, the three spent time this week performing refresher training on the robotic arm operations, performing numerous sessions of onboard computer-based simulation, and working with the ground robotic specialist to coordinate and fine-tune the procedures for that upcoming spacecraft, which will need the robotic arm to retrieve and dock it to the space station. Other activities this week included continued extensive work by Kevin Ford on maintenance of the internal thermal control system, checkouts with Robonaut, the onboard humanoid robot, and experiments. Maintenance work with the combustion integration rack experiment facility, as well as water processing assembly and laptop swaps in the Columbus module, were also completed. Experiment work this week was on a variety of experiments, including the binary colloid alloy study and InSpace, a study of the behavior of physical properties of fluids in response to magnetic fields in space, which may ultimately lead to improvements in the ability to design structures such as buildings and bridges on Earth. The International Space Station is an official U.S. national laboratory supporting a wide range of active experiments at any time. For a complete rundown of all the experiments and facilities on the space station, you can visit our webpage dedicated to the research on the International Space Station website at www.nasa.gov/station and click on the Research tab on the upper left. The crew's weekend will include a few routine housekeeping tasks and family conferences, but otherwise off-duty time after the busy work week. This is Mission Control Houston.